a warm greetings to one and all present here. I am Ms. Roshni of 12A, here to deliver a short speech on the topic Mahatma Gandhi, an Apostle of Peace. To begin with, let me start with an inspirational quote of Gandhiji. The best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Gandhi is the most famous Indian to walk on this planet. His signature toothless smile, gleaming eyes peeping from the circular metal-rimmed round glasses, wearing a lone cloth and a shawl wrapped over his lean frame, made him a hand-spin cotton anesthetic. If simplicity was given another synonym, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi would be that. Father of Indian nation, Gandhiji spearheaded the independence movement of India. An apostle of peace, non-violence was his weapon of choice. October 2nd is marked as the birth of great soul or Mahatma, he was called by Rabindranath Tagore. His teachings, his life lessons and way of life seemed to hold more relevance than when he was alive. This man changed the face of history, leading the resistance against the British rule in India, which effectively was the beginning of the end of the colonial era. For him, strength was the manifestation of mental toughness. Strength does not come from physical capacity, it comes from the indomitable will, Gandhi once said. Gandhi teachings have inspired and continue to inspire leaders from across the world. Gandhi is a hero not just to India, but to the world, said United States President Barack Obama. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born in northwest state of Gujarat, in the port city of Porbandar on October 2, 1869. His father worked for the government and his mother was a homemaker. She instilled the philosophies of non-violence, vegetarianism and simple living in young Mohandas. In 1888, Gandhi went to England to study law and after graduating, he moved to India, where it is said that he lost his first case. He packed his bags and went to South Africa, which was becoming a turning point in his life. He was thrown out from a first-class train carriage because of his skin color, which became a rude shock and then birthed an idea of self-purification and satyagraha, a non-violence protest. Gandhiji threw away his pinstripe suit and down the dhoti. Gandhi returned to India in 1915 and began his quest to take down the British Empire. He became the leading voices of Indian freedom movement, calling from a free India based on religious tolerance, equality for all and acceptance. He encouraged non-cooperation and urged all Indians to boycott British goods. In 1930, he led protests against the salt laws imposed by the British. The famous Dandi March was the symbolic act of the defense. This iconic image of walking with a stick and has been captured in statues. In 1942, he launched the Quit India campaign. After many events, finally the British gave in and India gained the independence on August 15, 1947. But this freedom came at a very high price. The country was divided on the religious lines to create two independent countries and India and Pakistan. Gandhi was assassinated on January 30, 1948. His dreams of a united India never came true. The mother of all ironies is that Gandhi, who spent his life preaching, practicing and promoting peace. Gandhi's legacy in its true manifestation goes beyond his inspirational quotes. It is inscribed in actions more than words. Let me conclude my speech by saying that the greatness of this man was his simplicity. Let's try and discover the Gandhi in ourselves. Thank you.